Hey guys, it's Hef. I am back again. You're gonna have to excuse the sunnies. It's quite early in the morning and the sun is like right there and I literally cannot see. It's throwing some weird shadows from my tripod. Not much I can do about that. And I need to get this video filmed. Hopefully by the next videos I film, it won't be quite so bad, but it'll still probably be really bad. So this is the update of the Love It or Lose It project pan that I started exactly a month ago with a whole bunch of lovely people from the Geeks and Beauties. Everybody who is doing round one will be linked down below. This is also going to be the intro for round two. So all the people who are doing round two will also be linked below. Some people are continuing on, some people are new. Everybody is doing theirs, kind of their own way, which is exactly what I wanted. The idea of this project is to pick between 5 and 10 items, use them for the whole of the month, and then decide at the end of the month whether you're going to love it and keep it, or whether you're going to lose it. And depending on what that product is, what that item is, you might decide to declutter it, throw it away, put it in the trash, burn it, I don't know, sell it if it's a high ticket item, or donate it if it's something that's still in good condition and you just don't want it anymore. So all of these things are completely up to the people who are in it, and no object is off limits for this particular project. It can be anything, anyhow, that you want. So yeah, there's some interesting products being picked by people. So I am going to get into the products I picked last time. The first thing that I'm going to look at is this poncho do flicky thing. I am going to insert a picture of what it looks like on. Now, I love the colour of this and the idea seems great, and I did wear it like twice, but what I found is this doesn't have like armhole slits in the side. It literally like just hangs over your arms, so every time you go to do something you end up with all this material moving with you. And I knocked over 2 cups while I was wearing it. Luckily they just had like instant coffee in them and I hadn't actually put hot water in it yet, so I had to be like really careful about stuff like that. And these tassel things on the ends, they like drag in everything and super annoying. And I realized because this kind of like bunches up around the throat because there's so much of it, and it makes you like really hot just around here, and I don't generally like stuff around my throat at the best of times. It's not like this is tight or anything, it's just like all this extra bulk here. And I wore it to walk my daughter to school, and yeah, I ended up like, my head just ended up like really hot because of all this heat around my neck. Yeah, which I just realised I really don't like. I just don't like anything around my neck. So yeah, much as it's like, it's kind of cute and I like the colour, it's just not practical for the kind of lifestyle that I have. And yeah, so I am actually going to put this in the op shop bag that we have sitting by our front door, and donate this to an op shop because it's just not, it's not my jam, basically. One of the other items was the scarf that you can kind of see hanging behind me. I actually didn't wear it like for the whole month, and I wasn't tempted to wear it at all, even on the like really cold days. And then I thought I'd try it as a hanging, but because of the way that it's designed, it doesn't spread out wide, it just ends up going really thin when you have gravity acting on it. So again, I've decided that I'm actually going to put that into the donate box as well, because I'm just not going to use it and there's no point in taking up space, basically. So they were the clothing items that I had in. The other things I had in were all waxes. Whoops. I actually only tried 3 of them over the course of the month. I was like really bad at changing them out. And I don't actually have one of them on me because it is in my bedroom and my partner is asleep at the moment and I'm not going to go in there and wake him up. And that is the shimmer one. I've actually burnt, I've actually melted 2 of the squares, like the little fancy squares. I actually melted 2 of them in our room. It's kind of, it's a sweeter scent. It's kind of a bit like cotton candy, but not cloyingly so. It's not like overpowering or anything, and it seems to be a good scent in the bedroom, so that one I'm definitely going to keep. One of the other ones I did melt is the Huckleberry Sage, and I actually really quite enjoyed this. It was kind of like, when I smelled it when I came through the front door, I actually really quite enjoyed it, and I wasn't sure if I was going to because of the sage, but it turns out it's kind of melony. Smells a bit like a melon, and I really quite liked it, so that one I'm keeping. And the one that is in the burner at the moment is Christmas Cottage, which I honestly didn't notice it too much, therefore it's obviously not offensive to me. Didn't get up my nose badly or anything, so that one I'm keeping as well. So that was good. The 2 that I didn't actually get to are the clementine clove and the cider meal. So, you know, it's fine. I didn't get to them. I'm actually just going to roll those over into next month. So, that's not a big problem. So that is the update on round 1. I am now going to show you what I'm going to be looking at in round 2. So, obviously, these 2 scents. 2 of them, and I'm adding in 2 more. One is my last of the scentsy ones that I have. This is Very Merry Cranberry, so that's a cranberry scent. So we'll see what that one's like. And the other one is one that is actually from Zany Laney. This is a new one to me. I haven't smelled it yet. I got this from Lena. And it smells interesting in there. It is the Chosen One, which is the Buffy scent. And it's supposed to be raspberry, coconut cake, and caramel popcorn. Literally all I can smell is the caramel popcorn at this point. So it will be interesting to see how that one goes. And the other thing I'm going to look at, my 5 to 10 items is kind of 5 items, but a lot more than 5 items, if that makes any sense. I have this container here of brushes. Now these are the brushes that sit at the back of my shelf because they're the ones I don't generally reach for. Because they're not my faves, and so I want to use them over the next month and then decide if I'm going to keep them or like toss them. Some of them I think might get tossed before they even get used, like this one from Calla, which it's supposed to be a, like, it says a complexion. It's not really dense enough, it just kind of squishes like really badly, so there's that one from Calla. I've got another, this one's also from Calla. This is more like a powder brush, but it's not like hugely soft. This is like literally dust coming off these. I probably need to clean them. It's not the softest. There's this one from Ubu, which again is supposed to be a complexion brush, but I don't know. This I used to use this one a lot, but it's quite a dense, very short bristled, but it's not like even. It's weird. This one is actually an e.l.f. brush. Powder brush. Most of these are like powder brush or complexion brushes. This one is from my crown kit that I got when I was doing my beauty training. These things shed like a mofo. This is a fairly dense brush. This is another one from my crown kit, like a blush brush type thing. Another one from my crown. I think it's supposed to be shader brush. This is also from my crown thing. It's not a great, it's like really flexible, and I don't know that that's a good thing. What else? I have these two fan brushes. I don't know where I got these ones from, but they're two identical fan brushes. So, I mean, I'll probably just use one and get rid of the other one. There's this one, it's also colour. Actually, I really like colour face sponges, but their brushes are, some of their brushes are a bit crap skin. And this is an e.l.f. stippling brush, which is dusty. Yeah, just like a little one. And lastly, this is a Lacura double-ended. I'm not sure what this end is supposed to be. Some kind of powder brush. But this is like an eye brush or maybe a concealer. I don't know. So they are all in there. I am going to try them out, use them, and probably if I don't like them, they'll probably just get decluttered. Those are the things that are going to be in round two of my Love It or Lose It. If you want to subscribe to my channel, click the button down there. Click the bell if you want to get notified of when I upload new videos. Leave me a thumbs up if you like project type videos. And leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments. And I'll see you in my next video. See ya.